This is literally from the outset, we're already having issues. Lol. This review is presented by EA Create Network, and what you see in this review will not be the final product. Also, to give you context before we start, this is my playstyle, and I feel like this is important so you understand what I'm kind of looking for in a game. I like family-oriented gameplay. I like random gameplay. I'm not a big fan of micromanagement. And I like depth and consequences in my game. If you want to learn about the context that happened surrounding this pack, then I'll leave some links in the description so you can read about it. So first we start off in Create Sim where there are no new traits or aspirations, but what is new? I didn't expect to get any, but doesn't make it hurt any less, to be honest. I always think that we could do with new traits. We also receive 6 new feminine hairs. 3 are the same, but with minimal differences because they have an accessory. The veil doesn't come detached as an accessory though, which I found quite bizarre. They're tied to a hair, which is why there's repeats of it, because you can't change the accessory because it's not an accessory. And I would have preferred the veils to be detached because it's more inclusive and also gives us more control and personalization, not to mention the fact that the only veil is for straight hair and it's also set to random, so expect your town needs to be ready to weddy. My personal favorite hair is this updo that has beads in it because it personally reminds me of Lizzie Bennet's hair during the second ball, the ball reprise if you will, in 2005's version of Pride and Prejudice starring Matthew McFadden. Absolutely beautiful film, do recommend. And we have some nice upper body accessories too, as well as these flower things, corsages I think that's the name. Maybe if somebody invited me to a wedding I'd know, but I haven't been to a wedding since 2012. So then in terms of clothing, we have 2 new tops for feminine frames. The suit jacket is actually unisex, and I'm very happy to let you know that I actually think it looks good on both frames. Wow, what a concept. And we also have 1 skirt. And then for full body outfits, we actually have a whopping 22 full body outfits for a feminine frame. I think that they actually do well in providing a wide range of styles, and I am a fan of a lot of them because some are more traditional and others are more casual, so not all of them fit this like stereotypical bride attire either. They could also be used for guests or bridesmaids or just general formal or party attire. And we also have 2 shoes. Very good, very nice. So just looking at items for feminine frame, I am a fan of the items that have been included so far because it sticks to the theme very well whilst also being able to fit into the wider Sims 4 game quite nicely, which is always what I'm looking for with Create Sim and Build By Objects. I will say though that so far I'm not a fan of the rainbow swatches because I don't feel like they're that tasteful. No offense to whoever made them. I genuinely don't mean any offense by this, but they come across as more clownish rather than LGBT, do you know what I mean? But apart from those swatches, the swatches that we've seen so far seem to be very versatile and they could be used in a variety of contexts other than weddings. So yeah, then we move on to the masculine frames and we only have 1 hair. Do I like it? Yes, I'm actually a big fan of this hair, but come on besties, really, like, we've been having this conversation for however long. I would love to see assets divided more equally. I mean, to be fair, we have only received 4 female hair so far, so there's not much to fucking share, do you know what I mean? But we could have had a bit more focus in the hair department all round. For men, we have 4 new tops, which again I'm a fan of, and other people might class this as lazy, and if you class this as lazy I completely understand and your opinion is valid and everything, but I really like how like 3 of these tops are basically the same thing, right? But it's kind of each version gets more disheveled, so you start off like full 3-piece suit, then it moves into the 2-piece suit, then it moves to your shirt half undone and your ties hanging off. I really like what they've done with it because I feel like it's an easy way to add depth and personality to your Sims, and it would be great for storytelling as well if you had like 3 formal outfits and throughout the night they gradually got more disheveled. And we also have 1 pair of suit trousers, which shock horror, I actually really like. I really like the fit of them, and I think that they'll be probably my most used suit trousers, and the don't have that American Sim style trouser fit. I hope you know what I'm talking about with that. But yeah, I would have liked to have seen more items for masculine frames. And we do have a pair of brogues. And for both frames, we do also have a multitude of wedding rings. Unfortunately, there is no wedding ring version of the eyeball ring. I don't know how I forgot to mention this, but we also have 12 full body outfits for men as well. Not necessarily 12 because some come with head accessories that should be separate. But I do really like the style of these. They do worry me a little bit, particularly these two, because they look very stylish. And I'm a bit worried that they'll age out of fashion very quickly. But that's not to say that they're bad. This one I really like. This one I'm a bit unsure of because it looks a bit like pajamas, I'm not going to lie. But yeah, the rest of them I really like. Kids have the same hair that adults have, both males and females, which I'm actually really glad of. I like that the Sims team are taking this thing of like just taking the adult hairs and just putting them on the child hairs because I think it works well. Feminine frames get 2 new dresses, which are cute, and masculine frames get 1 two-piece suit, and it's very charming. I like the swatches. And then male toddlers also get the masculine hair and female toddlers get the textured hair and also the pixie cut. So less hairs than other ages, but I also feel like it seems age appropriate. Toddlers don't really have long hair, and there's also also a new dress and full outfit for toddlers too. So I am glad to see things for every age category. And that is Creator Sim. I'm not the best at Creator Sim, honestly, and I spend the least amount of time in there compared like build, buy and gameplay. And I'm also a fucking whore for custom content. So it does take quite a lot to impress me with Creator Sim because I always take things with a pinch of salt. But I really do like everything that was included apart from the rainbow vibes. I feel like they could have been much more tasteful and like they really sell the vibe of the pack whilst also still making the clothing accessible for gameplay outside of just this pack. However, I do feel like they could have had more diversity across like the genders and the framing. Yeah, a little bit more focus in hair as well. I would have liked to see something extra there. I think any like head accessory should be an accessory and not part of an outfit, just to give you more control on the entire thing. So now from Create Sim, we head into Build Buy mode. And the first time I actually experienced this pack, I went straight into Build Buy mode and I built a wedding venue because I like to have a good experience before all of my hopes are absolutely shot. Do you know what I mean? And honestly, I absolutely loved this experience, besties. I really did. I will have a speed build of this wedding venue, but I had an absolute blast building it. And I really liked all of the objects that were included. It really sparked my inspiration for building, to be honest, which I've been struggling with lately. I really, really enjoyed it. We have 64 new buy mode items and 16 new build mode items, and I was impressed with a lot of them. They do definitely give you enough range to design weddings of different styles. Like, if I'm going to boil it down for you, if we're going to compare it to Pretty Little Liars, you could have an Aria, Hannah, Spencer or Emily wedding. So many bases are covered. And it also gives you the freedom to have a cute boho beachy wedding, but also a church wedding, which honestly I was a bit surprised at, because even in cottage living we didn't really get any churchy items, even though it's set in England, and England just have a fucking abundance of churches. Like, there's literally churches everywhere. And even the church items that we've already received in game so far, like in get together, seem to fall more in the gothic style than church, but these are straight out of a church wedding. And don't get me wrong, I love them, I really like the style, and I really think that they'll be useful in terms of building, especially because of the stained glass windows, which were an absolute delight to, you know, feast my eyes upon. But yeah, I was shocked, but it doesn't necessarily have to be a bad thing for me to be shocked. In terms of the rainbow style, I definitely think that the rainbow style was communicated better in build and buy mode than it was in create sim. I still think it could have been better, but I still think that the swatches that we've got and the styles that we've got so far with the build and buy mode items, I am honestly absolutely 100% obsessed with. And they really do give a range as well of like personality, because you can have your pastel core fantasy for all of the e-girls. It's me, I am the e-girl. I was very happy to be able to live out my pastel core fantasy with these swatches. They also have like the classic wood styles and everything, so they do suit variety modes. And there's even a new sand swatch, like a terrain paint, which go off, bestie. If the Sims team are watching this, or can I please put a request in, please? Can we please have more terrain paints of rocks with the, of grass with like the rocks on, like little pathways? Because the main one we have suits Willow Creek's grass, and I really feel like we need more diversity in that department, please and thank you. So yeah, that's build and buy mode all in all. I was really impressed with a lot of the items, and for me personally, the items that were included really inspired me with building and buying. But again, with this entire review, I think it's all down to personal preference. If you were looking at these items and they're not really inspiring you to build, or you're not thinking that you're going to use them, then it's probably not the build and buy mode catalog for you. Do you know what I mean? I was pleasantly surprised with how much I like the build and buy mode items. There seem to be a decent amount, although I'm finding it very difficult in the past couple of years to really define what a decent amount is. We've got so many different types of packs, and what constitutes a pack keeps evolving, so I'm finding that one difficult to navigate. But yeah. Now for the world. The world has 9 lots, which is a pretty decent size for a game pack, in my opinion. If this was an expansion pack, I would massively expect it to be bigger, but 9 lots for a game pack is pretty decent. As you load in the world, as it stands, you have a lounge, a rental, a wedding venue, 3 residential builds, and 2 empty lots. And the lots in this world was built by Game Changers, which, good to know. And the largest lot sizes are 50 by 52. There's no 64 by 64 lots. And there's also 2 new neighborhoods in the world. So we'll start with the smaller one, Terra Amorosa. Terra Amorosa is over the bridge. It's still got some buildings that like feature in the bridge, but it's basically, it's the one far away from the hubble and bubble of the town square. And a short trip from the coastline from Porto Luminoso is the loving land known as Terra Amorosa to the locals, where they're fishing off the boardwalk, swimming at the bottom of secluded hideaway falls, or hiking up the hillside to visit the area's famous lover's tree. Any Sim is bound to fall madly in love with the various charming sights and historic landmarks this lover's paradise has to offer. Sweet! And it's also home of the Markovic family. The Markovic family are locally renowned for their contribution to the musical side of the wedding industry, despite having put off their own wedding time and time again. Trouble in paradise. Mm-hmm. This is in no small part due to relations between them and the Laurent family being rather strained. Matteo believes that the Laurents have a stranglehold. Is that the saying? Is it not chokehold? On local wedding business, and works hard to retain relevance, while Lucia's animosity is directed at director, a former lover. All the drama and work has kept them busy and unwed. I feel like I'm in a fucking episode of EastEnders. Terra Amoroso is also the part of town that is home to the booby-looking willy tree that is so suggestive, I expected something to happen, but no. Honestly, the game said you sit there and look pretty, no interaction for you, babe. But it would have been nice to be able to at least send a wish to the tree or something, like wishing for a happy marriage, but no, it's just there so you can look at it and think of willies and boobies. And this part also does feature a swimmable area near the waterfall, which I honestly also expected the waterfall to be a woohoo spot, but alas, she was not. And then the livelier part of town is Porto Luminoso. Historians say Porto Luminoso's name originated when pirates arrived at shore, attracted by the glowing tides, the promise of trade, and the invention of the fruit tart. I'm a fruit tart for a price. Over time, the village flourished, and while still famous for its fruit tarts, Porto Luminoso's real claim to fame is its self-proclaimed title as the wedding industry's premier destination for romance and matrimonial services. It's also home to the Laurent family, which, you know, we've heard of. We are acquainted with them, but Laurent may be a newer name in the area, but the family certainly isn't. For generations, they've owned the local wedding venue, the cornerstone of the wedding industry in the area, and Hillary's family opened the first food stall in the village square back when they moved to the area. Now she's a chef in her parents' restaurant and the local food markets flourish. Together, this family forms a wedding industry powerhouse. And as for the vibe of the town, I actually really enjoyed it. I know that it's very obviously not meant to be this, but it really reminds me of Whitby, which is close to where I live, which basically means it reminds me of Europe, because Europe is like all close buildings, and I really like the style of it. And it's not all decoration either, which I appreciate. I feel like the gurus have definitely made an attempt to make the world around you interactable in terms of buildings. Like, they've incorporated food stalls into the buildings as well, so they're usable. And you can plan your formal attire from there too, which I expected more from that. I would have liked a walk-in shop or something, especially for weddings though, like a walk-in wedding dress shop. But I suppose if you have get to work, you can do this, but not everybody has get to work. And I also think that this line of opinion comes from my very solid opinion that I will not be changing, even though it may be unpopular. I do genuinely believe that we should buy clothes in The Sims 4, because at the minute, I kind of get it. There's no real point for a wedding dress shop when you don't buy anything. I would like you to have to purchase clothes in The Sims 5 and have retail stores like you did in The Sims 2. But yeah, because everything is free, it makes no sense. But there is also a florist where you can buy wedding bouquets from, which is cool. And you can also apparently buy wedding cakes from here. I could not find it anywhere. Granted, I do need glasses, wasn't wearing them at this time, and was also pulling an all-nighter when I was recording this. But literally, I spent a long time when I was recording gameplay for this looking for it, and I also spent a long time after I'd finished the script looking for it, and I could not find it, and I did have my glasses on the second time. So yeah, there is a cake shop where you can buy samples of cake and feed it to your partner, which is cute, but I could not for the life of me find a full size one anywhere. But we will talk more about wedding cakes later, because this isn't the only issue that I had with this. And then we also have a city hall, which I was really excited about, and granted it is a rabbit hole, but I feel like in a world environment like The Sims 4 where everything is a set, I'm not strictly against rabbit holes, and I think that they can work to the benefit of the game if they don't take away from actual gameplay. Like, for example, bowling should definitely not be a rabbit hole, but your Sims can get married at this city hall, which I thought was excellent. Or, well, they should have been able to, but with the version of the game I got, I couldn't get it to work. It took me so long for the interaction to even register, and then when it did, one Sim just vanished. I say vanished like she didn't pull a full gone girl, because my other Sim was still talking to her despite the fact that she apparently wasn't in the vicinity according to the game itself. I did get annoyed and I did kill them. Honestly, I did. But at least your Sims can go for a piss there. Go piss, girl. And this is a smaller point, but it's a point that is quite important to me. Apart from a few flowers and like vegetation that I could pick, I didn't find any collectibles going through the town. And this is actually something that I really miss, and why I tend to choose like the base game worlds to play in when I'm playing. I really like the collectibles around the world. I think it's even more important in The Sims 4 because the world is such a set and so much of it is not interactable, that having collectibles around the world kind of gives you an incentive to go around it, where at the minute the only incentive to go around it is like, well, this looks pretty, you know. I just really miss having collectibles in worlds. Anyway, that is the world. I like the style of it, and honestly, I'm a big fan of it. I do think I'll actually play in it a lot. I may be wrong, but I'm sure there was things about asking people around town about weddings. I may be making this up, but I don't think I am. But nothing like that happened to me. Nothing of the sort. And I also couldn't find any lore on Princess Cordelia. But I'm very willing to be proved wrong. If I am wrong, please let me know in the comments down below. I would be happy to be corrected. that I did see a lot of discourse around the Sims teams choosing to focus on weddings rather than choosing to focus on relationships or dating. And I also do definitely think that those aspects need working on. But I also, the premise of this pack really made me excited because wedding and stag party is my cup of tea, babe. I love the drama of it all. And I was very excited because I still have memories of the Sims 3 Generations where my Sims were literally dancing on tabletops. It was absolute, the drama of it all was beautiful. She was stunning with a capital S. Improved weddings is the type of thing that I will use in every single save. And I also believe that the Sims team are very good at taking like one small topic, for example, vampires and toddlers, and really excelling at it. So I genuinely thought weddings would be the same and I was excited. But unfortunately, the version of the pack that I was playing with was a buggy mess, which made me really sad. But that is the version of the game that I am playing with. This is not the final version of the pack. And I hope that if you do make the decision to buy this pack, then I hope that when the game gets released in a week's time, then it will be fixed. So let's go through it. The premise of this pack basically starts when you're engaged. So once you're engaged, there is interactions you can have with other people. You can ask them to be ring bearer, ask them to be flower person, ask them to be officiant. There we go. I also asked someone with a negative relationship and they were just like, yes, bestie, would love to. Yeah. Fuck my life. But there's also no chance to remove it. Like if you ask someone to be it and then you fall out, you can't just be like, no, you're not coming. You're not invited to the wedding. You just have to ask someone else and then they'll still both be invited. And there was no buffs around any of this, which I found quite bizarre because it's like, well, has it even happened? There's also interactions between Sims that focus around weddings, like enthusing about upcoming marriage or joking about upcoming marriage. And there's also another one, which is express doubts about marriage. Now you can imagine me, Chaos Gremlin, when I saw this one, I was like, yes, finally the drama that I've been waiting for. You know, I like to ruin things in my personal gameplay. It's all the drama, Mick. I just love it. But it had a positive fucking interaction and a positive animation. I was like, are you shitting my dick right now? And it had no negative moodlets after it. Like, granted, if two people are very emotionally mature and they discuss things honestly and openly and respectfully whilst respecting their partner's boundaries, like, I'm sure this could be a positive situation. But are you telling me if Bob and Eliza Pancakes had this conversation, it would be healthy? Absolutely fucking not. This would be full of guilt trips and everything. And at least it would make you feel like at least a little bit insecure, would you know what I mean? But no, didn't happen. And as I said previously, you can feed cake to your partner as well. But this has a worse negative animation than literally doubting your marriage to your partner's face. Like, nothing negative happened so far. And then from this, we move on to the wedding part. You can access the planned wedding event from the phone, and there's 7 things that you can do. Wedding ceremony, batch party, engagement dinner, family gathering, rehearsal dinner, reception, and vow renewal. And honestly, when I saw this, I was like, fucking yes, this is actually quite a lot, and I'm really, really excited about it, actually. So, obviously, had to start with the batch party, because you know how I am. I want my Sims to get juiced. I want them to be fucked up. And I was also excited when this came up, because I wasn't 100% anticipating this, but it's kind of similar to how holidays work, where you can choose, like, what you do. So, I love that vibe. It gives big event planner vibes, which I think is one of the best aspects of The Sims 4, honestly. So, for my batch party, I had to have toasts, grab a plate of dessert, dancing, drinks, and a celebration feast. So, I just picked the lounge to have it in. And I just want to just say right here, right now, I did give toasts. And if you're looking at why one Sim is giving another Sim an evil glare, it's not because the pack has repercussions. It's because my Sim had negative traits. So, that Sim just gave my main Sim the stink eye for the entire event. I don't know, things started to feel pretty stale. This is also where I encountered an issue as well, because it literally wouldn't even check off drink. I even checked it because there was 2 bars at this location, but no, it still wouldn't check off. And every aspect of this is micromanaged. So you click an event object and you orchestrate everything yourself. Now, as you know, I'm not a huge fan of micromanagement, but I do feel like this could play to some people's strengths. Some people really love micromanaging every aspect of the game. It's not for me personally. I quite like random events and not feeling like I have to orchestrate every single bit of it. I don't have that much of like a imaginative play. That's what my autism team said. But yeah, I do struggle with that kind of thing. So I really like random gameplay to like kind of drive things along, because I don't really have that innate ability in myself. And then the event ended and it was okay. I kind of enjoyed it, but I was also surprised to find that I had no notification or buff or reward after this had finished. Like, I kind of imagined it going like a party, like a timed event where there was something at the end of it. It didn't really feel like it happened because there was no evidence that it happened. Honestly, I could have done this without the pack. Like, I expected at least aspiration points. Do you know what I mean? But I I kept my head up, I soldiered on, and I thought the engagement dinner would be better. So I held it out at a coffee shop in Windenburg because I thought it was the best option. There's no restaurants by default in the game, even if you own dine out. Like, as you're loading the game as it is, no restaurants. But unfortunately, this also fell a bit flat because the event goals were all the same. And once again, very micromanaged. And also, it really wasn't streamlined. I had to order a cannoli like 5 times just for it to register. I think maybe it could work better with other packs, which is a good thing. I do like cross-compatibility of packs, but I feel like it would need to be, you know, I feel like it'd need to have enough sustenance in and of itself before I credit it for working well with other packs. I was a bit disappointed by it, but I also still kept my head up, still soldiering on. We'll try the rehearsal dinner. And I didn't get very far in this because I couldn't invite my fucking fiance. Like, I'm really trying to stay positive here, besties. I really am. And then I'm not gonna lie, yes, I really did get disheartened after I tried the 3 activities and they were all the same. They were basically the same thing, just with a different name. They were the same interactions and everything. It felt very lackluster, plain and boring because nothing random happened. It was just the same thing. So I just decided to just bite the bullet and just go straight for the wedding. And I also met an issue with this. I could not figure out how to buy a wedding cake, as I said earlier. Like, I literally looked everywhere for it and I couldn't figure it out. So I thought, well, it's absolutely fine. Cooking is fantastic in The Sims 4. I'll bake a cake. I knew you were coming. I had to bake a cake. But to cook a wedding cake, you need a level 5 gourmet cooking skill. That's fine. I cheated that, got there. And then I really hope that this is a me issue, but it didn't give me the option to cook a wedding cake like we'd seen in the trailer and promo packs for it. Yeah, it was very frustrating. And if it was there and it was an option that I missed, then I don't think that that part of the pack was very streamlined if I looked everywhere for it and I couldn't find it. So I cooked a tea a wedding cake, which was not the one that we've seen in the live stream. And it wouldn't let me set it as the wedding cake, even though it was a wedding cake. But I also couldn't find out how to access the wedding cakes that we'd got with the pack. But, you know, I just took it in my inventory and the rules, took it to the wedding with me. But you know, I'm glad I kept my hopes up and kept soldiering on with the pack because there was more options for interactions with the wedding. So for the wedding event, we've got blow bubbles, speeches, first dance, tea, walk down the aisle, exchange vows, drinks, throw rice, cook cake, dancing, spousal kiss, celebration feast, and have toast. And my hopes were back up, lads. Like, honestly, I thought this was going to be so much fun. One thing that I especially liked about this as well is not everything is mandatory, which I really, really liked. The main thing that stuck out to me is the spousal kiss. If I ever get married, I do not want to kiss my spouse. Sorry, it's literally not personal. So I like that didn't have to be included. So yeah, that kind of like perked me up a little bit and genuinely thought we were going to have so much fun. But again, everything happened through micromanagement, which is just not the play style for me. Again, by clicking in on an event object and orchestrating everything yourself, even having people walk down the aisle. But an issue that I had as well was even with this micromanagement, it just still didn't work a lot of the time. So I played around a bit. I had guests take the seats, which I was very excited about, but this was also buggy. A child went fucking rogue in the ocean. We were soldiering on. So I micromanaged my Sims to get wedded by their officiator and kiss after the actor exchanging rings, but they wouldn't. They literally refused to get married, and not in a drama way, just in a bug way. I had to try a few options until they finally decided to exchange rings, at which point they done on loop again and 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 didn't even kiss at the end. All of this for what? Yeah, pretty much every aspect of that was buggy. And then also just for a bit of drama, because I wanted to see what would happen. Even though it was micromanaged, I thought, well, can we micromanage drama? I invited the groom's secret lover, right, who also happens to be secretly pregnant with his unborn secret child. All very much a secret. The other groom doesn't know. Just to see what would happen. And she actually ended up crying in the pews, which I was like, fucking result. Until I read the situation properly and I realised that she was actually crying from happiness. Make it make sense. I tried to get her to object or anything, but like nothing. There is no option to create drama. So even if micromanagement is your playstyle, you can't micromanage drama. You can only micromanage positive, happy things. Even if everything gets fixed and all the bugs get fixed, this is a definite drawback of the pack. The fact that it's all happy and sparkly and nothing bad ever happened. I want fucking drama. I want lives to be ruined at weddings, right? What if my wedding story is a bad one? I'm left-handed, left wing, and left at the altar, babe. How am I supposed to make that happen in The Sims 4? But yeah, after she wouldn't object, I thought, well, you know, let's just get to cutting the cake, doing the slow dance bubbles, etc. Half of the stuff wouldn't tick off and half of the guests also wouldn't join. So my groom cut his cake alone. The other groom didn't turn off. And my grooms also wouldn't do a spousal kiss, so I couldn't tick that off. And like, I also think it's important to know that these Sims were in my active household. Like, it was a small wedding with everyone that I could control. So I can only imagine the chaos, not in a good way, if you had a big wedding with people outside of your household. So yeah, at the end of the wedding, there was no buffs or prizes or points or anything. It felt very underdone and half-baked. Even if everything worked worked properly. If everything worked properly, it's just a happy, it's a happy simulator. It's a, you do not have mental health difficulties. I want to portray this in The Sims 4 simulator. I just want chaos. I want chaos always. And you can't get that, even if everything worked properly. That is a major drawback of this gameplay. So all in all, I feel like Create a Sim, Build and Buy Mode, and even the world to some extent is a very successful part of the park, and it does really communicate the narrative of my wedding story as well. I wasn't a fan of the overly micromanaged behaviour of The Sims and how nothing was random, with every action being orchestrated with me. However, I do feel like some Sims will love this. Sorry, I also just forgot to mention that I literally couldn't find the wedding topper, so I couldn't put the asexual wedding topper on. Rude. But yeah, I would have liked to have had the choice or have any negative reaction. I think choice is always what it boils down to, because some people love micromanaging, some people really don't, and just kind of having the option for both so then you can please both players. Just a smidge of chaos at the least, please. Like, honestly, I felt like this game pack feels like a mod, but I feel like mods would have came with chaos. But yeah, I felt like a mod that was broken by a patch than playing with a new game pack. So I feel like the pack is very buggy, and it's a huge shame because I find the world, Build, Buy and Create a Sim to be very strong, and it's the gameplay that really lets it down. I think even if the bugs get resolved, I will still use the gameplay aspect of it. But if you're looking for any meaningful, deep gameplay, I would maybe give this one a pass. At the very least, until it's fixed anyway. I wouldn't buy it in its current state, unless you're desperate for like the build and buy mode and create some items. But this is also not the final version of the pack. For the price it's at, I would give it a pass at the minute, because this pack would just annoy you. Also, if you're wanting to download this pack because you want the drama of weddings or you want to add chaos and spice into your life, I would also maybe miss this pack. This pack is definitely like a very much rose colored glasses simulator. So yeah, that is everything that I have for you today. I love you all so much. I hope you enjoyed this review. I'm very glad to be getting back at them. I love you all so much. Please subscribe if you haven't already. As I said, thank you to EA Creator Network for giving me a copy of this pack to review. What you've seen is not the final version of it. I do hope that they bring updates to fix everything. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I love you all, and I'll see you so much. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, bitch.